Buzz, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. The Tigers have shown over the course of the season that they want to get this guy the football, but you can't just go to him every play.
Well, on the road, you especially want to take the crowd out of the game, and the one guy you know who can do it is this wide receiver. The problem you have is this defense, more often than not, is going to be aligned to take him out of the game. And that, to your point, Brad, that's where somebody's going to have to step up, whether it's the running game, some of the other receivers. You're going to have to take some of the pressure off of him and really make it a team effort to be able to win this game on the road.
There are a lot of players in the college game that can make something happen when the blocking breaks down. But when it's that bad, I don't care who you are, you're going down for a loss.
Second down at 14. Ball on their own 20. He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Pulls it in, first down, and he's knocked out of bounds.
This isn't even the best example, but I'm going to tell you something. This young man is really getting better at running his routes, which is a truly underrated quality these days.
They call it a catch, but the booth signaled down to the referee that they'd like to take another peek at this.
Man, as I see this play again, it really looks like he made the correct call on the field.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands.
The ruling on the field will stand. He caught it.
The only thing left to say about this play is that was an excellent catch.
Hand off, and he's met immediately. From their own 31-yard line, second down. Setting up the play action. Has time. He sails it long. Keeps his eye on it. Makes the catch. Tackle at about the 31.
Once this guy gets into the secondary, he can be a real problem to bring down. He can shake off a lot of tacklers who are smaller than he is.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
Woo! I think everybody in the stadium felt that hit. He really laid some lumber there.
He's under some heat. He's out of bounds, right around the 28-yard line. Couple of yards at most on that pass.
Usually you get a linebacker covering the tight end, so they might want to try some longer passes to exploit that mismatch.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Complete, brought down, nothing doing. They couldn't get the first down.
Well, here they're hoping to get a few extra yards after the catch. Give the defense credit, they held him short.
Trying to take the lead by a field goal. The kick is up, and he got it. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Sledge takes it to 12. He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. Gains his way to the 46-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 46-yard line. The ball pops free, and they fall on the loose ball. So the offense turns over the pigskin.
The ball carrier here was just careless in handling the ball. And a great awareness by the defense to jump on it.
A scoring drive the last time out for this offense, and they'll huddle up for this drive. And the halfback's got nowhere to go.
And that was the freshman linebacker who was right there to make the play.
From the 48-yard line, second down. Run left side. He fights forward to about the 46. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. He's got it with room to run. And he's tackled at the 33.
We've got a change at the quarterback position. You've got to wonder how that's going to affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just going to try to ease him into this game at the beginning.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 33-yard line. He's taken down around the 25-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
Man left, man left. Four down, four down. Mike Ford, Mike Ford.
Run, 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 run. They'll bring him down at the 26. Loss of 1 yard. They need about 3 yards to get the first down here on third down. Kicks up, and he nails the long field goal. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Lewis fields it at the 13. Tackle made at the 33-yard line. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
You don't change your philosophy after one play. They'll be out doing the same thing as before, just with better awareness.
Tate gets about a yard on the play.
That makes it second and eight.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. Can't get away from the pressure.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers. They looked a little sluggish on that series. I'm curious to see if they pick things up when they get the ball back.
Thorn is the punter. Booming kick. He gets out to about the 28-yard line. Well, the last drive was good for three, but I'm sure in this one they'll be looking to double that. He's taken down at the 36-yard line. After one quarter of play, and we've got a low-scoring defensive battle on our hands. The Tigers in front, 6-0. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long range yards.
We've got a first and 10, ball on their own 49. Brought down to the 39-yard line. They get a one-yard loss on that one.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From the 40-yard line, it's second down. Hand off inside. He's tackled at the 37-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Tackle made at the 24. And this play is number 8 on the drive. Here he's going to scramble, and down he goes at the 11-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 11. And they make the stop around the 15-yard line. This is the 10th play of the drive.
Yeah, let's go set first.
Mike Ford!
Caught and a big hit. He stopped in his tracks. From the 11-yard line, third down. He gets it up, and he's got it. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Sledge takes it at the 16. It's scooped up. Tackle at the 32-yard line.
Can this defense play any better? I mean, these guys have a great tradition. They live up to the billing today. Now we're starting to see whether or not this team can get it done. And if they are, then I think the defense should go down to the offensive side of the field, talk to their own offense, and try to get them fired up to go out there and get some more points on the board.
And they got him for a loss.
You can't teach instinct. The ability to know where a play is going is something this safety has. That was a terrific effort.
We've got a second and 14. Ball on their own 28. They come out in a five-wide set. And he's hit before he could go anywhere.
Boy, this defense is doing a great job of bringing pressure. That time they brought a blitz and allowed the defensive line to break loose and get to the quarterback.
These special teams have done it before, blocking punts. It looks like they're coming after this one. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Lost the ball. Fumble. Picks up the fumble.
Well, it's always fun to be part of a defensive battle. That's certainly what we have right now.
Yeah, give credit to both of these defenses. I mean, they're playing with a lot of energy, and I think they're doing a nice job up front at the line of scrimmage. And at this point, they're not giving either of these offenses a chance to make a play.
A fumble ended this offense's last drive. Let's see, as they come out on the field, what they'll do this time around.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
And a corner on the interception. Pass in daylight. Tackle at the 31-yard line.
Boy, just when it looked like they had a chance to get right back into this game, they throw the interception. Now it's still early. Let's see if their defense can bail them out.
From the 31-yard line, first down. And he just gets rid of it. And they get him in the backfield for a loss. Third down, and they need to get it to the 21. Offense lines up in a five-wide set, and the defense anticipating pass here. And he's tackled at the 27. It's up, looks long enough, and he splits the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sledge takes it at the 16. He makes it to the 32-yard line. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. They'll line up with five wide receivers. Caught open field, and he tackles him hard at the 49-yard line. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
First and 10, ball on the 49. Quickly, and they got it. Touchdown. The wide receiver flew down the field on that touchdown connection.
Well, he has the speed to stretch the defense, and his hands are getting better every single game.
The coverage just couldn't keep up with him there. kicks on the extra point.
A quick two-play, 68-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Low-scoring first half of play, but a close game. The Tigers lead is 5.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit, but great game, living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
That's going to do it for David and me here in the studio. Time to get you back to the game. Brad and Kirk ready to take you home in the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Lewis takes it to 12. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Nice catch, first down, and he's knocked out. From their own 45-yard line, first down. Quick strike to the receiver, and he's taken down at the 40-yard line. So a nice little pitch and catch there, and that'll give the offense a first down.
That was a very good-looking pass play to get more than enough yards to move the chains.
Shoved out of bounds at the 34. From the 34-yard line, second down. He's pushed out of bounds at the 23-yard line.
I credit the quarterback on that pass. He made a great read and delivered a very nice pass for the first down.
Makes it to the 11. He really showed some good speed there.
I'll tell you, no question. When you talk about being able to turn on the jets and leave everybody in the dust, you have to mention this young man. He's got skills, but his speed is what the pro scouts are drooling about.
Passes left, gets it out to the halfback. What a play to set him up with a first and goal. Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big game.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice game for the offense.
West with a nice play fake. Now he's scrambling. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown. You don't really gain anything by kicking the extra point here, so they'll go for two and try to go up by three. Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. And they won't get the two.
looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Every single time this offense has the ball, they're moving the football, but they're settling for field goals. And every time they settle for field goals, I've been watching the defense that they've been facing and watching how they run off the field to celebrate a job well done because they're not giving up touchdowns. That's a bad sign.
Here's the pitch, and now he's got the corner. They'll bring him down at the 33.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Here he goes. Makes it to the 41.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. First down.
Hey, defense, let's go. Pick it up, Pete. Mike Ford.
He's got it with room to run. He's brought down in the open field.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 48. Nice run there. Fights forward to about the 39. The running back gets two on the carry.
Not much gained on that play because this safety did a wonderful job of getting up there and making a good tackle on the ball carrier.
Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Pitches it. He's got the corner. Gains his way to the 26-yard line. Tackled for a loss.
Well, I think it's safe to say the defense had his number on that one. It can be very frustrating for a running back when he stops before he even gets going.
So it's second and 13. Ball on the 29-yard line. Throws to the receiver. Incomplete.
Number 86 was the intended receiver on the play.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Taken down around the 29-yard line. The completion won't even be close to the sticks, and that's going to bring up fourth down.
Well, they'll give him the short yards in that situation just as long as they keep them from getting a first down.
And he can put his team in the lead right here with this field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. Like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles couldn't get much going in the first half offensively, but they've really got it going here in the third quarter.
I think this is a great example of just making the right adjustments at halftime. The staff got together, made the adjustments, and boy, this quarterback and this offense have gone out there and found their rhythm.
They got into the end zone last time. Let's see if they can match that on this possession.
And it was a really nice drive too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. He makes it to the 42-yard line. He's at midfield. He's tackled at the 48-yard line. That makes it first and 10. From the 48-yard line, first down. Scooped up by the offense. Throws it out and it falls incomplete. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 38. They bring him down.
Boy, Brad, that was a big hit on his quarterback. We'll be interested to see how he responds from this hit and whether or not he comes after his offensive lineman and challenges them to start playing a little bit better.
Three down and one to go. The Tigers in front by two. Great three quarters of action, tight ball game, and now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Thorne is the punter. It's away, and it's a booming punt. He's tackled at the 25. Well, I can say this much, Kirk, at least it's tight in the fourth quarter.
It is a close game, and neither team's been able to get anything going, whether it's running the football or throwing, and look up at the scoreboard, and at least, as you said, Brad, it's a close game. Who can make a play late to win it?
So this game tight here in the fourth quarter, but now it's a chance for them to put this thing away.
This is picture-perfect defense by this corner. Great job of providing run support.
From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Oh, boy, almost intercepted.
How did he drop that? The defender did everything that he needs to do. He read the play perfectly. He stepped up, and what does he do? Drops the interception. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Screen pass. He's got his halfback. Good possession there for the defense.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it fourth and eight.
Lewis is back deep to return the punt. He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt.
I love the competitive spirit that we're seeing out on this field today. It looks like one team has the upper hand, and then the other comes right back in to be able to regain the lead. It's going to be an exciting finish.
Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ball game. Down at the 41-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. And they get nice yardage on that run. It out to about the 40. From the 40-yard line, first down.
Here we go, deep, all day, deep, all day, all day.
gets it out to maybe the 39-yard line. A one-yard gain by the halfback.
That brings us second and nine.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From the 35-yard line, third down. At about the 39-yard line. The kick is away. It's long enough. No good. He missed it to the right. You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Quick strike to the back, no good. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 39. Line.
Nothing tentative on that run at all. He looked very determined and got the first down.
Nice play across the middle. And down he goes, right around the 32-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 32-yard line. The quarterback in the gun. Empty backfield. Five wide receivers in the formation. Fires out to his receiver, and he's tackled at the 25-yard line. The Eagles are going to have to call their third and final timeout. Just under two to go in the game. Throws it in a hurry, and they make the stop at about the 19-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 19. Just couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage. Loss of one. That'll bring up second and 11. And that sets them up with a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. And this should be a kneel down as they just try to kill the clock. The quarterback takes a knee, and that's always a good sign if you're a fan of this team. The Tigers, coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That brings this broadcast to a close. For EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler. We'll see you soon for another edition of NCAA Football 14.